I've just received this little CD104 from eBay. Now apparently it works, but the drawer sticks when going back in, which is a common fault. Like so, need to push. So I'm probably gonna change the drive belt. So I'm just gonna take the screws out, and there's four in total, two on each side. And then just a matter of lifting the top off. So here we go. So this machine looks original. A lot of dust inside, and it doesn't look like it's been got at. So one of the first things I do is use a wee bit of isopropyl alcohol and just clean along here. Roller. Now some grease has been put on this before, but sometimes it can be burrs and whatever, and it's just good to keep clean it, kind of clean it off. But also along the top here. You know. Right, the drawer as well. There you go, boom. Still not great, but you know, definitely better. So another thing you can do is adjust this keeper here at the side. Lift it up a little bit, this sort of like locks in the disc, just give it a wee bit more room. Makes it a bit better, but again it's still sticking a little bit. So after a bit of cleaning, the drive is still sticking. It's not as bad, but it still is sticking. So what I'm going to do is take the mechanism out and take the little belt compartment off here and change the belt over. So there's a number of screws to take out. Some of them are quite recessed. The first one I'm going to take out is one at the back here. It uses a torque for these screws. I think it's a torque H2 in this, whatever that is, but it's a small torque screwdriver. So that's one out there. I have another one here. There's another one here. Coming looser. So I think there's one in this corner here, which is difficult for me to get because I've got a daft screwdriver. So I think I have to take the front off here. So there's three screws, the top and a number on the bottom. Be able to see things a little bit easier, more easily. Yeah, three in the bottom. Front panel should come away. So here we go. So that lifts off. There's a screw there, which is a little bit tough to get. So that's what I'm trying to get out. This is a bit bodgy. I didn't have a proper torque screwdriver, but I have a very fine flat blade screwdriver, which is enough just to get in the torque sides there and take this out. So that's a bit bodgy, but saves me having to buy a thin torque screwdriver, but maybe if I'm doing this more often I'll get one. A bit of luck, now the mechanism should come out. I'm just going to take the disc out here, just in case that gets damaged. This is tight, so yeah, there we go. That's it coming out. Now if you can see here, that's the motor and that's the belt, so I'm going to just work on that now. I'm just going to take the top screw out here for the drive belt assembly. Okay, that's the Torx screw. And there's a couple at the bottom as well, just on the side actually here. So it should be a matter of getting this belt off. I put like a wee hooker thingy. The belt's actually quite tight, so yeah. So that's the old one off, which is not quite easy. This is a new one by NanoCamp from eBay. A nice blue colour. So there we go. So I guess you just maybe give this a bit of a clean. Just the roller here. And that sort of thing. And I think what we do now is just put this over. It's a lot thicker than the one that was on it, so we'll chunky job. Hopefully to get this in. Because it's a lot thicker if it was down this side. I've got a pig's ear of this. There we go. And then use my little tool. Hook it over. So I suppose this should be square on as best as possible. At least it sort of fires off. So, yeah. Seems like it's going to work. There. So it's a good opportunity now, well, this is all apart, to kind of lube this machine up a bit underneath. So I have some gun oil, very light lube oil here, and I'm going to put tiny drops on some of these moving parts here. Like here, just very small, like obviously you don't want this getting anywhere near lasers and things like that, so you're kid gloves, you know. There's obviously different ways of doing this. You know, you can use grease and all sorts of things. Just using what I have at the hand. So you can put this belt back on here. We just do the motor as well and do these. Don't really want to get in on the belt actually. Maybe just a wee tiny bit. Just putting a couple of screws in here again. It's a little bit tricky lining this up. You have to engage this little flywheel here at the side and also the gear, but it's not, you know. If you're handy enough, you know, that'll be a piece of cake. So I've learned something new today. You better put this in first, this little bit here, because there's like a little hook that goes in to the tray before you screw it down. I'll just take these screws out again. Of course, I should really have disconnected this from the machine. It'll make it easier than working on the machine here than doing this kind of malarkey, but sure. So I've got the motor on there as you saw, just checking the drive moves in and out. There's quite a lot of resistance there, you know, so I'm going to just clean in here now as well. So the old cotton buds come in handy, you know, and the old alcohol. Drink a bit of it as well if you want, it's going to be a bit. Yeah. I'm just using a little bit of isopropyl alcohol here to clean the laser assembly. And I'm going to use a very fine cloth just to wipe that down. You want to be delicate with this. Don't use something too harsh. And the platter as well, just give that a wee bit of a clean. Or the disc surface that meets the disc. But this thing's a real beast. I mean, it's lovely quality material, you know, it's really nicely made. Some shock mounts. You can see why these players are sought after. I probably will mod this with the NOS mod, the oversampling and clocking mod, which I'm going to start making myself, because you can buy these wee bodgy boards here, which are great, but I'm going to build a proper circuit board with this, and I'm going to sell it reasonably cheaply on eBay. So if anybody's interested, they can pick one up there, hopefully in the future. Okay, so I'm just putting in the screws now. Or dropping them into the machine, actually, is what I'm doing in actual fact. But yeah, put these screws in. So just going handheld here. Hopefully you can see. I'm using my bodgy screwdriver to put this screw in here. So some of them are a little tricky. And then it spins. Boom. There we go. I assume it's playing audio. So I just have to put it back together again. The screws back in the top and the bottom. And the cover on. I did lose a bit of something along the way. So a little bit of plastic, which is slightly concerning, but hasn't seemed to affect the player, you know. So I adjusted this little effort here, this little keeper, and it does make a bit of a difference. This tray is a wee bit tighter now. So to do the NOS mod, which is remove the filter chip in the machine, which Philips put in back in the day to make it sort of pseudo 16-bit. First of all, I have to take off the bottom cover, so that's just more Torx again. So, you get the glorious inside workings. This is pristine, you know, it hasn't been messed with. In some way, I'm sort of thinking, do I really want to kind of mess with this? Because it is so nice. If you have a look, you know, it's just beautiful with the copper and the nice laser here, and yeah, the whole thing. Work of art. So the IC that generally gets replaced is this up here. Right, something like this, which looks hideous. What you also have to do is alter one of the pins on here and take it away from ground and make it 5 volt. And what that does is instruct this IC, the SAA7000, to become 14 bit. So to do this mod, it's just a matter of removing a couple of these multi-plugs. Just nice and stiff, so they haven't been removed before. You're best pulling them by the side of the plug rather than the wires. Although this can be a little bit on the tricky side, if they've never been removed before. This means you don't stress these wires, which can be problematic. Some more Torxy screws. I think there's two, just one there. So it's got a little washer. Which what you can do as well is you can actually, if you have the top board out, just do it without removing this board at all. This is the data from the laser. So to do this properly, you really do need to take off the screws for the power supply and take the power supply heat sink off the back. Get this board out, because it sort of hits this jobby here. There's a multi-plug in here, it's hard to see, but if I can just get it in shot. There's a multi-plug there, needs to come out. Another thing you need to do is just take out this wee grommet so that the audio leads are free to move around. Need to get the board out. Of course, you probably will find that some of these wires come off because they're really flimsy. You really should put decent quality connectors on this player if you disturb them. But that's easy fixed. So these cables suck big time. They're really awful. They just snap off. I mean, it's, you know, I'm not a great audiophile, as in replace every cable you get and every piece of equipment. But if you're going to replace one cable and one piece of equipment, this is the player to do it with, because it's just naff. And of course, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to bodge this up and get it working. But definitely a nice set of gold plated RCAs in the back of this, or even decent cable just coming out, will make just mechanically a bit of difference. I mean, audio wise, who knows, but definitely mechanically, because this sort of stuff's just going to break off and it's just trouble waiting to happen, you know. So this is the IC you want to be desoldering. It's a SAA7030A. It's a filter chip. So I'm just going to desolder it on the bottom here with my desolder gun. Like so. So I'm just going to do the rest of this here. So that's it out. I'm now just going to put it in a socket. So just soldering in the socket. I'll redo each corner and then I can just make sure it snaps nicely in place. Like that. And I can do the rest. So the next thing we want to tackle is this IC. So here's the other side of the board. So what we have to do is run a 1K resistor from this pin to this pin. Now this pin needs to have the solder sucked out of it and the pin not touching the track here. You could cut the track, but I prefer just to desolder round it and then just attach the resistor from here to here and use a 1K. Doesn't matter what tolerance or anything, just a 1K. Reason for this is that this chip requires 5 volts on this pin rather than ground. So here we go. Now that's not touching the sides. Of course some people might like this and say, well, what happens if it touches it? But it probably won't. So there's quite a bit of difference there. You know, it's not likely to touch it unless it's really pushed hard or something like that. But you could, as I say, cut this track to be on the safe side. I like this way because it's reversible quite easily without having to mess about with repairing tracks and things. So that's my final result there, just the 1K across it. While I had the player opened, I thought I'd have a look at the power supply. Now there's a lot of old caps in here and I have replacements. So I might just change some of them out, at least the ones I have replacements for, because I discovered there actually was a fault with this machine. It turned out that a lot of the capacitors were completely like foobar, I mean really bad way. You know, this kind of thing here. Hardly any capacitance, sometimes showed up as resistors and things like that. So that's probably why one of the channels was very, very low in the output. So replacing all the capacitors, redoing the griplets, which are, you know, little holes in the board, and also just like a full reflow and resolder of the board, sorted that out. Screw it up, try it out. Put the new chip in, of course, which is here. Observing polarity, which is this way around. I'm just going to screw this up here. Just to finish off the video, the player now seems an awful lot better and the drawer opens and closes nicely. So the new belt really helped things. The low channel was sorted out with the capacitor swaps and the griplets being done. Kind of classic things that you need to do with this machine, and there's lots and lots of stuff on the web of how to do that. So hopefully you enjoyed this short video, and if you like this kind of thing, please check back for more electronic and synthesizer videos. Thanks very much, and I'll see you next time.